of a lifetime. In this episode, I'll be exploring the coastline of East Devon and Dorset on a walk through time as the coast path cuts through some 185 million years of the Earth's history. I'm starting at Beer Head in Devon with its distinctive white cliffs.
These are the most westerly chalk cliffs in England, and to understand more about them, I'm going to have to tear myself away from the coastal path and head underground.
The limestone in the cliffs at Beer Head has been one of our most highly prized building materials since the Roman times. For almost 2,000 years, it was quarried here at Beer Quarry Caves.
And near as they got a bit of machinery, there's a crane.
Today, John Scott runs the caves as a museum.
This whole thing is so unexpected, especially that thing. That's the last thing I expected to see at the entrance.
Unique, mustn't it? This church window was actually carved down here in 58 pieces by candlelight in the spring of 1492.
And that is a great example of how fine this beer stone can be carved, isn't it?
Oh, yes, because it's got no fossil remains in it. It's ideal for very fine detail carving, but when you take it outside, it dries a creamy white and becomes five times harder.
And whereabouts is beer stone now?
Well, you can find it in Westminster Abbey, Tower of London, Hampton Court, Windsor Castle, and 24 cathedrals.
So Beer Village is, you know, sort of the home of cathedrals. Really.
Well, they often say that it's a birthplace of cathedrals.
I'd love to see how the stone is extracted, John.
Well, let's take you down to one of the old working places and see exactly how it'll be done.
Thank you very much.
It was quiet, yeah?
Over the centuries, 75 acres of space was carved out from Beer Caves, entirely by hand. It feels like a vast underground cathedral, but for the quarrymen who created it, working conditions were hell.
Well, I'm glad we were together because it's a long walk round here and I absolutely definitely would have been lost.
There's no way you can stand in this place and appreciate the sheer physical size.
And every single bit of it by hand.
Cut out by hand. There's never any machinery was used here at all.
Well, it's like a monument to just plain hard graft,
isn't it?
It is,
yeah.
But how did they do it? How did they actually cut this stuff?
It was an evil job. I mean, not only was it dangerous, but you'd be single-handedly expected to cut a four-ton block of beer stone out of a blank rock face every day to earn your living.
A four-ton block every single day?
Now, you've got to imagine, you've been working like this 14 solid hours, soaked in sweat, you're totally exhausted, you can stop. But you can't go home. Now you stand here shivering, you're waiting for a man called the Tapstone to come, and he carries a hammer. And after all the work you've done, you know when he hits the block of beer stone you've quarried, if it doesn't ring like a bell, doesn't ring true, but gives a dull thud, you'll know the stone is cracked, useless for a mason to carve, so they won't pay you a penny wages for what you've done.
Oh, no. Bears some thinking about the true cost of this stone, doesn't it?
That's right.
The caves and the stories they tell are humbling, and they would have been lost forever if it wasn't for John.
How did you become so involved with this quarry?
I first got fascinated when I was a kid. I used to come down here with some of the last of the old boys who worked here. And some while later, I heard that the quarry company who owned the lease at the time were going to blast the whole place flat. So we managed to stop that happening in an effort to try to preserve it and keep it open so future generations can see what our ancestors did.
That's fantastic. So you actually saved this place?
Well, basically, yes. I mean, it came within a few hours of them about to blast the whole place flat.
Wow.
Otherwise, it would all be gone by now.
It's unthinkable that these caves were nearly destroyed. But thanks to John, they're a haunting reminder of the extraordinary efforts that went into quarrying this highly prized stone.
Mm-hmm.